Are developers going too far in the pursuit of growth? That's a question some are asking in Nashville's most historic neighborhoods.
News Channel 5's Kyle Horan joins us live. And Kyle, some on Jefferson Street are saying they've approached their approach multiple times a week by people who are looking to buy.
That contact comes in the form of mail, in person, or by calls. But every single time someone contacts these businesses, they're looking to replace something here with something newer.
Jefferson Street is one of Nashville's most historic neighborhoods. Unfortunately, for many of its longtime residents, that history is troubling.
So red line is referencing the discriminatory housing practices called redlining that have sort of set the stage for a lot of development and gentrification.
Just ask Omari Booker of Woodcuts. His art speaks directly to the issue of growth and its legacy of racism.
Kind of in the 1930s, they drew lines around neighborhoods and said that black people could live in this area, you know, white business people could live in this area. And so they broke it up into these sections. And the redlined neighborhoods were the neighborhoods that were built for African Americans or immigrants.
While the neighborhood may have survived the worst days of segregation, it may not be able to survive the rapid growth of a city on the rise.
I have seen people kind of displaced, but also known people personally.
It's happening to people who are homeowners, but also developers are looking to expand onto Jefferson Street itself.
It's been about a weekly approach to buy the lot. The offers get pretty sweet. You know, you kind of really have to have some not only some foresight, but also an understanding that it can't be driven by strict capitalism. It has to be driven by more than that.
Booker's artwork reflects this change, showing tall and skinny new development next to older homes, most of the time owned by black families.
There is that level of tension when this huge place goes up next to these people's older homes. It's kind of like the writing's on the walls. It's like, you're not going to be here very long.
That sentiment is shared by others, such as the owner of this barbershop or this wings restaurant. Both have been approached by developers. Both don't know how long business owners can hold out in a city on the rise.
Some business owners I talked with says that they believe that when they don't sell, someone will report them for a codes violation. One of the business owners I talked with today actually didn't want to talk for fear of retaliation. Reporting on Jefferson Street, Kyle Horan, News Channel 5.